I need a spot welder. After searching for different off-the-shelf solutions, I ended up asking Vevor if they would send me their 737G spot welder. And they did. The welder came with two sets of tips, two spare fuses, foot pedal, holder for 18650 cells, and two different sizes of nickel plated strips. By default, this will weld automatically when the arms holding the tips are pushed up. There's a switch inside that detects when the arms are in the up position. Alternatively, foot pedal can be attached, which will disable the internal switch and the pedal will be used as a trigger. How hard one has to push to reach the switch is adjusted using the knob on the top of the machine. Markings on the top state the range is between 200 grams and 700 grams, which I haven't measured. But it is strong enough for strips that this machine is designed for. Other adjustments include power and pulse count adjustments. Power is adjusted between 0 and 99, so basically percent, and pulse count can be either 1 or 2 pulses. On the side there's warning about or recommendation of quite highly rated circuit breaker. We have two 30 volt mains here in Finland and I can confirm B10 type circuit breaker, which is quite fast 10 amp breaker, definitely isn't enough for this welder. On the other hand, less sensitive old style 10 amp fuse that is protecting some of the older outlets in our house is enough for power levels up to 80% on this welder. That is plenty enough for the strips that came with this machine. With proper settings tuned in, I can do weld after weld with constant results. I found 30 to 35% power, 2 pulses and pressure knob turned 1.5 turns back from the maximum to be good for these thinner 0.05 mm strips. And same but 50 to 55% power to be good for the 0.1 mm strips that came with this welder. So if there are three different adjustments, how do I know which one I should adjust? I'll start from the settings I have found to be good for T-strips and batteries. Now if I reduce the power significantly, either the strip won't stick to the battery or it will come off really easily. There were no sparks, no color change caused by heat, almost as if nothing happened during welding, because nothing happened. On the other hand, setting the power too high causes too much heat. Slightly too much power will cause strip to weaken around the weld, and even higher power can burn through the strip immediately. It's always best to start with too low power and find out proper setting by increasing a little bit each time, to avoid damaging the battery. Damaging these lithium cells can cause fire or other dangerous situations. Next setting is the pulse count. There are many descriptions, for example preheating, cleaning the surface from oxidation, keeping temperature in correct area longer. Whatever is actually true, common conclusion is that the dual pulse will give more consistent results. Third setting is the pressure. Too low pressure increases the contact resistance, which will cause excessive heating at the wrong place and there will be sometimes quite spectacular sparks. Unlike many first-timers think, higher pressure doesn't mean better welds. While poor contact is a bad thing, pressing tips too hard against the weldable material will make the better contact and decrease the resistance too much. Current flowing through the resistance is what causes the heat that welds two parts together. Too low contact resistance means there won't be enough heat to fuse parts together. Overall, this seems like an easy-to-use welder for hobbyists who want to make some battery packs. Some may argue that one could make similar or better device using microwave transformer, microcontroller and some extra components. While internals of this welder and those microwave oven transformer based welders have the same basic principles, I would much rather recommend someone to buy an off-the-shelf product than to tear down a microwave oven and modify its powerful mains powered transformer. This 737G welder has a dedicated transformer for the welding current and a controller port that has its own power supply, microcontroller and triac that is used to turn the transformer on for welding. After a couple hundred welds with this machine, I haven't had any problems with it. I'm still using the first pair of tips, which are still in good shape. Even though I can't use the full power with any of the outlets I have inside the house, I'm happy with this welder and this will definitely come handy when I need to rebuild some battery packs in the future. I'll put link to this welder in the description along with site-wide discount code. See you in next video. Thanks. Bye.